Good afternoon, everybody. So, you know what's the one thing I've always wanted to experience in my life? It's the feeling of being rich. Now, being rich is known, or rather classified, as an individual having heaps of money. The amount can be anything. But the truth is that the more you have, the more you're known for being rich. An individual is classified as being rich when he or she owns the world's most expensive car, rather than buying a car that is averagely priced. An individual is classified as being rich when he or she owns a private jet or lives in a mansion, other than living in an apartment that would cater to your needs. However, the major drawback in today's society is the way we subject the term rich. And by that, I think everyone here can agree, is that individuals who tend to spend their money on the world's most unnecessary things are the ones who usually receive the fame. However, in the contrary, to the people who spend their money cautiously are the ones who are sidelined. As I previously mentioned, an individual is classified as being rich when he or she spends their money on the world's most luxurious thing. And in modern society, many people are judged on the basis of what they wear or what they own. And I'm talking from personal experience because I've witnessed ample of scenarios where my own friends are judged on what they wear to a specific outing or how much they can spend on a specific outing. Many people tend to ignore what the other richest people around the world are spending their money on. The fame is always focused towards the stars who spend their money on the world's most expensive number plate. However, the fame is never focused towards the stars who are helping the unfortunate by providing them with resources and amenities to eradicate the troubles they have to face in their everyday lives. And by that, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to focus on the term choice. What an individual wants to do with his or her money is completely dependent on the person on themselves. It's up to them on how they want to spend their money. Personally, I feel that there are two types of people in this world. One, who want to earn a lot, but who want to spend it on themselves and their family. And two, who want to earn a lot, want to spend it on themselves and their family, but who also want to give back to the society. And let me make things a bit simpler by providing you with some examples. Who here has heard of Dan Misery? Well, okay. Dan Misery is known as an international playboy. He's known for making his money through playing poker. Now, I think that everyone here can agree with me that earning your money by playing poker is something that no one should be known for. But then again, it was his personal choice to go forward with decisions to be known for the person he is today. He's known for passing derogative comments towards women. He's known for misleading, mistreating women. But then again, it was his personal decision. Not everyone is Dan Bazarian, and by that, who here has heard of Bill Gates? Well, a clear difference can be seen. A lot of people have heard of Bill Gates. Now known as the world's most richest man, he has a personal net worth of over $85 billion. He's known for founding the number one software company known as Microsoft. Now, if you think back to what I previously mentioned about choice, I believe that it was his personal choice to actually go into that direction, to provide a solution to internet users so that they have an easy to go usage in the internet field. But a lot of people tend to think that, oh, Bill Gates is the richest man, he's going to be stubborn, he's going to be arrogant. But that's where the mistake lies. Together with his wife Melinda Gates, they founded the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. With a personal endowment of over $45 billion, they work hard to provide the unfortunate with what we have in our everyday lives. They've educated millions of children about technology that is so vital in today's era. They've educated them about the diseases they have to face so that they can't, and they can prevent them from happening. And that, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to focus on the term being rich in the wallet or being rich in the heart. Now, a lot of people might wonder why I've put Mother Teresa's picture here. And can anyone take a wild guess as to why I've chosen this picture?
That's not she's rich in the heart.
Exactly. Mother Teresa once said that anyone can have money. You can buy money, you can get money. But as long as you have a heart and you make the right decisions through your heart, that's how you know. Anyone can be rich in the wallet. Dan Bilzerian is rich in the wallet. But is he rich in the heart? Bill Gates, on the other hand, is rich in the wallet. And I think everyone here can agree that is rich in the heart. I am rich in the wallet. You all are rich in the wallet. But we need to think back to ourselves. Are we rich in the heart? Now, I'm not saying that a person is known for being rich in the heart when they donate millions and billions of dollars to help someone. It's the small steps that you can take to be known for that type of a person. It's the decisions that you decide to make. It's the choice that you decide to choose. Thank you.